Welcome to Papa Junk Shop. Now let's take a look at number two here.
Let's get an overall general look at what we got. Well, the tank's completely dry. So I would guess that probably there's a hole on it someplace. Yeah. I think there's epoxy on the bottom of it. We'll know in a bit. Let's see what I got underneath here. I'm assuming a rotten air cleaner. Oh yeah. That's what I expected. Okay, let's see. Choke is frozen up. It's always, well, the throttle does move. Just the idle screw is screwed out quite a bit, so. Okay, so it does turn over. It's got compression. So next we'll see if it's got spark. We'll get a spark plug wrench. Looks like we got a little bit of concrete. Well, it's stuck there, so I'm not going to disturb it. Okay. Let me pinch together a little bit. Oh, boy. Kind of a shut off on it, so looks like it's another one that's going to need the points clean. That's pretty much to be expected though. Okay, so we'll get her apart and get the points cleaned, and then we'll squirt some gas in it, see if it runs, then we can tackle the carburetor, I guess. Yeah, let's see how we make out getting the flywheel. Good spot right there to get a little pressure on it. First whack. All right. Okay, I think that's a quarter inch. They are. So I'll get a point file, get them cleaned up, then we'll see if I got a spark. Points cleaned up, got them back together far enough to check it. Oh yeah, I got spark. Okay, so now means that we got to get a little spark of gas. Oh yeah, before we do that, we better see if there's any lubrication in her. Yeah, it's not all the way up to the top, but there's enough. Okay, we'll just give it a little dab in there. A little dab in there.
spinach. Alright, so she's going to run. So, carburetor's the next challenge. And I got to say, I don't care for them. Now, it's been a few days. And my next thing was going to be to work on this carburetor, but I decided that I took the gas cap off, and it really doesn't look that bad in there. And I thought I felt epoxy on the bottom of the tank, and thinking that's why it was bone dry, because it leaked out, but I think it was just some concrete stuck on there. So I got a borescope. I'm going to take a look down in there and see what it looks like before I take it all off and try to do something with it. I'm going to try it. So I'll see if I can let you guys look too. Not sure how it's going to work out. Yeah, I'm going to give a try letting you guys say what I'm saying. See, don't look that bad in there. There's a little rust spot there. Oop. Okay. I'm going to give it a try. Okay, hopefully you guys can hear me okay, because I got the air conditioner running, because it's just wicked humidity out. And of course, the air conditioner is noisy, and of course, the inverter's working, so its fans are running too, so. Okay, here we go. Gotta open the vent a little bit. For a trial. Don't feel anything leaking out. Choke's froze up. I forgot about that. Oh, there she goes. Guess it is. Did pull her. Okay. So I'm going to use a drill. Choked. Oh, I managed to get the nut loose. Okay. I'm going to get some gas and squirt in it. See if it'll pick up. Okay, I got my little squirt bottle here. Give it a little taste. You know, I didn't really expect it to. Every once in a while you get lucky. Just for fun, let's pop this out, take a look, see what it looks like. Ooh, the thing's coming out. Ooh, it's nice and clean. Definitely, I'm not going to get away with it, but we're going to try one more time. Nope.
Okay.
Should have just taken it apart to begin with. Now I got the majority of the crud off of it. And these check out okay. You can blow through that way and the check valve works on both of them. So that's a good thing. So I think I'm going to address this thing here. See if I can get this work loose so I can adjust it. Wow, that is not going to move. Now, let's try warming it up a bit. Yeah, a little mini torch thing here. This is when they started cheaping them. They used to be brass. This is aluminum. See what that does for it. Yep, there she goes. She turned a little bit. Oh yeah, that's warm. Ouch. It's hot. The old pliers are laying right there, dummy. Why don't you use them? Should have picked the socket, shouldn't I? Put that in. That would have stayed in there. Well, it moved now. When it cools off so I can hang on to it, we'll get it out of there and clean it up a little bit. That looks nice and clean in there. I don't know if that'll come out easily. Well, okay, it's gonna. Amazing. Oh yeah, I can see light through that. It's nice and clear. So, I'm thinking it's probably the diaphragm that's the problem here. I don't know if this screwdriver's too fat. Deeper, that turned easy, but this really doesn't fit. Let's see, I got one right here. This one probably now. These diaphragms are quite troublesome. The old simple ones might have been a little finicky once in a while on the depending on the level of fuel in the tank. Where these had a, well, this pumps it up into a chamber tray here and keeps this full, so you have equal amount of gas to draw from all the time. It keeps it more consistent, but it's more complicated too. So, you know, pretty sure I had these diaphragms. Been a long time since I had one apart, so I'm gonna pay attention here. She's stuck on there. Ah, yeah, she's been a long time since I've seen any gas. Come on. Yeah, got some stuck on there. I have to get that cleaned off. It's nice and clean in there. And this goes right into this port here. That's where it gets the pulse for the fuel pump portion of it. So look in my collection, see if I got one. Found one. Nice and flexible. It's the only one I got. Last one. You can see what this one is. You can probably hear it. So, I got these all cleaned up. Got that old stuff all cleaned off of there. Blew all these passages out. Check valves are all working. So, I'll get this spring assembly back in there. Oops. Get this stuck in there. Needle seat back in there. Okay, this thing should be cooled off enough now. Okay, I'm going to clean that up just a little bit, put her back in there, we'll get her assembled back on the engine. Okay, got her back together, got some gas in it. I felt sorry for the tank and threw some paint on it. So, let's choke it, see what happens. That governor ain't gonna work right because I don't have the shroud on, do I? Yeah. Take a minute and throw the shroud on it. Okay, let's try it again. Thank you. smoke's coming from all the oil that's on the outside of the muffler, I do believe. So, a little more TLC, I think it will be a useful piece of equipment again. But for right now, we're going to call this one a video. We got her running. I got a lot of other projects that I need to look into before this one gets any more TLC. So this will make a nice winter project sometime. So we know it runs and it's worth the effort to spend a little more time on it. So if you enjoyed this one, give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, please do. Thanks for watching. See you next time.